Welcome back, everyone. Let's talk about variables now. Now, you can probably guess by the name, a variable is something that is variable, meaning that the name or val the value of it is not always going to be constant. So by explicitly stating strings, they're not reusable as well. If I wanted to, say, let's jump into a Python console. All right. If I wanted to create a string, not using variables, this is a string, I could create that. However, there's no way now for me to reuse it to do something else. So I'd have to do this is a string plus hello. And then there's no way for me to reuse that one. And so you can see the problem. Now that's one reason why we use variables is so we can reuse the variables. Now another reason is because when you pass values into functions, it's going to take on the form of a variable through the parameter list of the function. We'll get more into functions later. Now the difference between Python and some other programming languages is some programming languages are typed. And you might say, well, hey, aren't all programming languages typed? Yes, you type them with your fingers on a keyboard. However, a typed language basically means that you need to define the type of variable. So as we learned in the previous videos, the different types are like integers, strings, booleans, and stuff like that. So if you were setting a string variable, you'd have to explicitly tell the program that it's a string. But with Python, you don't need to do that. All you need to do is give your variable a name and a value. So let's go ahead and let's create a variable called greeting. And it's going to equal a string that's going to say hello world. Now, you'll notice when I hit enter, it didn't print anything on the screen and it didn't do anything noticeable. And that's because setting a variable doesn't have any type of response. So it just creates a variable and it's there. Now we can use it by using greeting. So I could type print greeting and it's going to print hello world. Now also, now that I've got it in a variable, we can manipulate that variable in a number of ways. So I'm going to type greeting equals greeting split. We're going to split it at the space, and we're going to set it to the first item. So basically what we're doing here, and I can't use double quotation or double equal sign there. We're setting greeting to a new value, which is going to be greeting, which we're going to split at the space. So we're going to split it right here, and we're going to get the first item in there. So it's going to turn greeting into just hello. Just hello. So let's hit enter here. We've assigned it a new value. So if we now go ahead and print greeting, you're going to see that it says hello. So now what we can do is now concatenate this with something else. So we can do that in a number of ways. We can reuse the previous example where we just well, let's just print it out first. We can print greeting plus a Nick, and it's going to say hello, Nick. Now, if we wanted to store that in a variable, we could do the same thing that we did before, or you can continue using this variable for different people. So I could say hello, someone else. And so that's how that works. Now, if I did want to make the greeting equal to concatenate a string, all you'd have to do is redefine it as greeting equals greeting plus Nick. Now, when we print out greeting, you'll see that it says hello, Nick. So that's a variable and the useful things that you can do with it. Now, you can also assign values of other types. So we can say number is going to equal 1, and then second number is going to equal 2. So now we've got number and second number stored in variables. Let's do something with that. So what we're just going to do is add these two numbers together in a print statement. So print number times second number plus second number times number. And this is going to print out 4. So essentially what the print statement is doing is before it prints it out, it's calculating this because we've stored these as integers. And so it's going 1 times 2 plus 2 times 1. So it's essentially saying 1 times 2 plus 1 times 2. And it's coming up with this. So, and as well, you can set check equal to true. So that's how to set variables. It's pretty simple, and we're going to be doing a lot of this. So this is a concept that you're going to have to be very familiar with and get used to using it. In the next video, we're going to be talking about some built-in functions, and we've already actually talked about some of them.